Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video I'm going to create this look. So I have a little bit of bad cold. So I have a little bit of cold, so I have a little bit of difficulty in talking, but yeah, I tried my best. So you find a little bit of different tone of my voice. So but for today's video I'm going to show you the beginner kit. So these are all the products that I have bought. Makeup, I have used all those products to create this look, and most of the products are under 500 or almost around 500 600 rupees, but one product is there which is a little bit costly. And yeah, if you want to know all the beginner kit, then keep on watching. And also, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell. And without further ado, let's get started. So let me tell you, when I started, I invested some money for, you know, less price product, and also I have started using some high-end and also low-end. I did not go for very low-end, like I never went for very high-end and or maybe very low-end. I was always in between these two. I have little bit of sensitive skin. I don't want to use a very cheap product and then I have some, you know, I create problem for my face. And also, yeah, I always went for a little bit of in between option, not too good, not too bad. The first thing is moisturizing your face. So before doing any kind of makeup, make sure to moisturize your face, and it should not be used. Don't use a lactam calamine kind of thing which are quite dry to your face. Now the first thing in the makeup is primer. So the primer I would suggest you to buy is this one, the Wet n Wild. You can use a aloe vera gel primer like the Patanjali one. I don't have that. Even the Lakme one also you can use, but I have pores in my face. As you can see, pores, there are some holes, and these are going to show up if I don't use a pore filling primer. Either I like to use this Maybelline Master Prime primer. This is also a pore filling effect. It fills all my pores I have in my cheeks and nose. Or you can go for this Lakme one. Is, I think both of them are a little bit at higher and around 600, but if you have pores, you need a pore filler. So I'm going to show you how the Lakme one shows. So these areas I'm going to, and near my nose, I'm going to fill my pores. It will give a very even finish, and it has a little bit of color, but that's okay. Once we use the foundation and all, it's not going to be visible. Now next we are going to move on to the foundation. So foundation, I think if you ask anyone, for the beginners, this is the only foundation you can use. This is also, it is so illustrate, like if you get discount at Nykaa or Myntra or anywhere, like you will get it at around 400 or less than 400 also. So this is the good recommendation, but the bad thing part of it does not have a pump. So handling this product is a little bit tough. Now I use the shade Warm Honey 322. This is actually perfect match for me, and it has a lot of shades also. Now if you don't like this kind of thing, you can go for stick also. The stick also comes in darker shades. So I use the shade 330. It is toffee. So very good. Like, now I know everyone is talking about Fit Me only. Now other than Fit Me, if you want to buy a reasonable rate, low end, under 500 rupees good foundation, I would suggest you to buy this, the Wet n Wild foundation, the Wet n Wild Photo Focus foundation in the shade, I have the shade Desert Beige. You know, it has darker shades also. It has a shade called Toffee which is quite dark, so you can go for it if this has darker shades also. So yeah, and lot of low-end foundations I find they don't have darker shades, and you know, you end up looking more white, your face ends up looking more white. So today I'm going to wear this foundation and show. And also this is quite matte, like it is more matte than this one low. So people like me who are having oily skin, they are going to love it. So I'm going to mix these two foundations, Maybelline Fit Me Stick foundation in the shade Toffee, because this one is little bit lighter to my skin tone. So I'm going to mix this two. So you can see it is quite, like if you want a stick foundation of Maybelline Fit Me, this one you can go. It is quite matching to my skin tone. It looks quite dark also, you can see. So I'm going to use this makeup sponge. So this makeup sponge and the brush, I got it from Amazon. I think I paid some 200 rupees and got this kabuki kind of brush, which is very good for, you know, spreading the foundation. Like, you know, if you want to blend the foundation, it is very good, this kind of kabuki brushes. And this sponge, I got it. In generally, the beauty blenders, whatever you are having, if you soak it in water, they are going to expand. But this sponge, it is, as it is in lower rate, it is very inexpensive. You will not get it at, it is not going to expand if you put it, dip it in water. But yeah, it is going to solve the purpose. Like, you can blend it. You can blend the product. Now next, I'm going to add little bit of this foundation and show you how it looks. Now for brushes also, when I bought for the first time, I went for very affordable option. So what I did, I bought from Myntra this brushes. These are from Fulzi. You will find it in Myntra. And this is how it looks. It has a beautiful container also in it, and it has pretty decent amount brushes. Like, all the big brushes are fluffy brush, and you have a spoolie for combing your brows, and you have a this kind of brush for blending your eyeshadow, and you have this kind of brush for brows, and also for this flat brush from concealer. This all till now I use it for concealing my eyelids. Today's video I'm going to use this to show you that you can create good makeup using this kind, this brushes also. Exact thing is not available, I've checked it in the website, but yeah, these Fulzi brushes are good. You can use it, and they are very soft and fluffy. I think the Vega brushes that I used to have earlier, it was so harsh on my face. Now for concealers also, I always go for affordable. Still now also, I have a lot of high-end concealer, but I don't daily basis go for high-end concealer because you end up using so much of money for concealer. So the concealers are from Wet n Wild. I have two shades. One is from, I think, medium dark, medium deep, and another is light medium. So it depends. Like, sometimes I am more tanned, I use the darker shade. If I am in winter, I am a little bit less tanned, I use the lighter shade, or maybe the lighter shade I use to highlight a little bit. So, and also if you get more deeper shade of this, you can use to contour, cream contour your face also. So these are very good, blends very nicely, very good coverage. And I think in Myntra you get a discount, and under, I think, 400 rupees, 339 or something, you get it under discount. So definitely go for this. Now Fit Me foundation concealers are also good. I go for this two concealer. This is the Fit Me Maybelline Fit Me concealer. One is in the shade medium, and another is shade in the shade cafe. Now one more concealer I think I use till now. So I make videos every day. I can't go for everyday videos or everyday makeup 5000 rupees 3000 rupees concealer. It is not possible. So what I do, I do go for this LA Girl Pro concealer. This is a very good concealer gift. So today I'm going to show this Wet n Wild concealer. So yeah, this also has a little bit of orange tone in it. Next, I'm going to take the same Wet n Wild, a little bit of lighter shade, and I'm going to highlight. And if you find like your beauty blender is soaking, or the makeup sponge you are using, they are soaking more product, then dab it very lightly, very light handed. Then it is not going to soak more products. So next, I'm going to set everything with the powder. Affordable one, and you have shades also in this. This is the one, this is the Rimmel Stay Matte Long Lasting Pressed Powder. And you have, it retails at ₹250, and also you get lot of shades in it, like caramel toffee, and lot of darker shades you have in this. And also it holds your makeup for long time. For today's video, I'm going to use this. So I'm going to take the makeup sponge and pick up the powder. So this is what I'm going to do for my under eyes only. This will make sure my under eye does not crease at all. While you are doing, putting the makeup sponge in this, make sure it is not too much wet, it should be quite dry. This is the powder brush. I'm going to take the powder and lightly go all over my face so that we have all the cream space are set nicely. Now I like to bake my under eyes. If you want to lose further to bake your under eyes, you can go for this. This is the Lakme 9 to 5 natural finishing powder. The price of the product is 550, but this is a very good product it sets your under eyes so nicely, and also it has a little bit of satin finish in it, so because of that your face is going to glow a little bit. So I'm going to take this powder and take my makeup sponge and dip it and bake my under eyes so that it does not crease. Next, I'm going to bronze my face. So bronzing your face, either you can use a darker shade compact powder or you can use a bronzer only, the best bronzer I think ever which is available at India is this one. This is a Wet n Wild contouring palette. I have the shade Camel Toffee. It bronzes my face so nicely. Or you can go for this one, the L'Oreal Glam Bronze. So this is also a good product. So for today's video, I'm going to show you how can use this Nykaa compact powder to bronze your face. I have the shade Cozy Chestnut. It is little bit darker to my skin tone, and also you have more darker shade, I think Toffee or Caramel, one more darker shade you have. So you, if you are darker than my skin tone, then definitely can use that one. So I'm going to use the same powder brush and I'm going to bronze my face. So I'm going to take this brush to slightly contour my nose. Next, I'm going to apply some blush. So Wet n Wild has very nice blush. I think it retails at ₹300, and if you get a discount, you will get it for lower price also. They are very good, very affordable. So this is the shade Pearlescent Pink. One more shade is a Mellow Wine. It is quite good for darker skin tone. Next, I'm going to move on to my brows. So for brows, the most affordable eyebrow product is this one. This is from Wet n Wild. This is the Ultimate Brow Kit. This is a very good product, and you have, you know, I have in the shade Ash Brown. You have light two shades, one lighter shade, one darker shade, and also the gel product. I really love this product. I think this is the most affordable brow product, and it is so much pigmented. And if you are a beginner, definitely working with powders for your brows is quite easy. So I'm going to quickly finish up my brows. So in my brush kit, I do have a spoolie like this, so I'm going to use this to comb my brows. And also I have a flat brush like this. I'm going to use this for my brows, to fill my brows. Next, I'm going to clean under my brows. So I'm going to take this flat brush and I'm going to take a little bit of concealer to clean up my brows. Next, I'm going to talk about eyeshadows. So you can skip the eyeshadow primer if you use some concealer for eyelids. And after using some concealer, make sure to set the eyelids. So for the eyeshadows, the best eyeshadow I know, this is also from Wet n Wild. This is the Wet n Wild Color Icon eyeshadow palette. It has very beautiful matte shades. If you are going for matte shade, definitely you can go for that, and it has so many colors. The shimmery, I must say, they are not so good. Yeah, definitely you can work out. Now if you want a shimmery eyeshadow, you can go for this highlighter. This is the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Highlighter Powder in the shade Precious Petals. This is a very beautiful highlighter. You can use it on your eyelid, or you can use it as highlighting your highest point of your face. And the highlighter and the eyeshadow palette comes under ₹500. Definitely you can go for it. And also you can go for this kind of eyeshadow palettes that Wet n Wild having. Now in the affordable one also, you can go for Maybelline. If you want to go the Maybelline, old eyeshadow palettes are not good, but the Gigi Hadid collection palettes are very good. They have matte shimmer, they are very good. The shimmery ones, like they shine, you can see they shine like anything. They are very good quality, so, and they are quite buttery also. So yeah, the other City Mini palettes I did not like it so much, but I find like the Gigi Hadid collection, they are creamy, pigmented, they are very good. So I'm going to take a fluffy brush which is available in my Full 3 palette, and first I'm going to take this lighter shade to define my crease. this match and this palette, they are not so good, but the shimmeries are very good. So if you want to go for matte shadows, definitely go for this Wet n Wild eyeshadow palettes, this one. So for you, the transition shades, they are quite pigmented. I'll show you. So for kajal, either you can go for this Lakme kajal. These are very affordable, and this is the first, I think, kajal I have used ever. Or you can go for this Wet n Wild kajal. They are also very affordable, and they are very good black and matte finish also. Or if you want a gel liner, either you can go for this Lakme 925 natural, or you can go for this Maybelline gel kajal. This is also very black matte. This is a little bit of shine and this is a little bit of black. I have a comparison between these two. I'll provide the link here. So for today's video, I'm going to use this Wet n Wild gel liner. Next, for kajal, if you want a smudge proof kajal, you can go for L'Oreal Infallible or Plum kajal or the Nykaa IM 24x7 kajal. So I'm going to slightly tightline my upper and lower lash line using this L'Oreal Infallible kajal. So my eye makeup is done. Next, I'm going to move on to mascara. So if you are a beginner, don't buy a waterproof mascara. It is very hard to get off a waterproof mascara. So the two mascara options I have is this one. This is the Maybelline Lash Sensation Mascara and the Maybelline The Process Push Up Drama Mascara. So both of them are not waterproof. I love the Lash Paradise also, but you know, getting that means it is a waterproof, and to get rid of that mascara is very tough. Now for lashes, the best affordable options are the pack lashes. These are the shade pack M75. They have M74, M76, and a lot of pack lashes which are very fluffy, and you can find these are similar to the Samantha lashes. It looks so beautiful, and I think it costs around 295. They are very good. Now this does not come with a glue, lash glue, so you have to buy separate. So for glue, I don't want you to buy a very cheap quality, otherwise it is going to infect your eyes. Or you know, eyes are very sensitive, you don't want anything which is not good. So I have been using this duo glue from the very first time, beginning time only I'm using this duo glue, and I don't have any problem. I don't want to invest in any of my money where, you know, it is where you can hurt your eyes. So better if you can't afford a, you know, high quality or costly glue, don't go for lashes. But if you are going for lashes, make sure to use a very nice good glue. So next, I'm going to move on to highlighter. So I'm going to use this the Wet n Wild Mega Glow highlighter in the shade Precious Petal. Now if you want to go for 550 rupees and you want a blinding highlighter, go for this. This is very good, and this is having more glow. Like, I'll show you this. You can use it as eyeshadow also. This is such a glowy highlighter. Like, you can see it gives a very highlighted effect. So yeah, now this is my current favorite. It gives a very beautiful highlighted effect, and I also like to highlight my cupid bow. Next, for lipstick. So before going for any lipstick, make sure to line your lips. It is very important. So either you can, I have some from Lakme and some from Maybelline. Lakme's are also very good and creamy. Even the Maybelline ones are also good, very good. I have 2-3 shades of this, and they are very affordable, and you'll get any store. Next, for lipstick, like, nowadays matte is the trend. If you want to go for a good makeup tutorial, you have to go for matte. Now from matte lipstick, there are a lot of options. You have Miss Claire very good quality and low price. You have Stay Quirky, very good quality, low price. And also you have Virgin Oil, very good quality. I think under 500 rupees you will get that. And if you don't want too much matte, you have very dry lips, you can go for this kind of Maybelline matte. Maybelline also has some matte lipstick which are quite affordable. I think with discount you will get under 350 rupees. So this is one, and they also have one more different kind. They are very good quality, but they are not total matte. But yeah, if you have a dry lips, definitely go for this. Now some more lipsticks are there which are very cheap, and some are under 300, some are under 400, or almost around 300. So one is from In Color, I have this shade, and another is from Nika Cape. These are two matte lipsticks. These are also matte finish. So for today's video I'm going to use this one. This is the Nika Cape true matte lipstick in the shade Wine Berry. It is a very bright dark color. I have not worn such a bright color for a long time. It is slightly patchy. I think the darker shades may look a little bit patchy, so let's wait for it to dry completely. Meanwhile, I did a bronzing, I did not do contouring. So I'm going to create a shadow here. I'm going to take this darker shade from this eyeshadow palette. You can use this eyeshadow palette for blush, contouring. Now what I like to do nowadays, I like to apply a gloss on top of a matte lipstick. So I'm going to use this. This is an Lakme Absolute Plum and Shine gloss. This is a very beautiful gloss. I like to apply this slightly here and slightly here. So I think almost I'm to the end. Next I'm going to take this yellow banana shade from this palette, and I'm going to highlight some certain areas of my face. So I'm going to take my makeup sponge and highlight my face. This is also very pigmented. You have to be very careful to pick up this product. And once it is done, just take your fluffy brush and blend it. So lastly, I have forgot to mention that you can go for a finishing spray. I don't use finishing spray so much because I have quite oily skin. But you can use this Virgin Oil finishing spray. It retails at rupees under 500 only. This is a very good finishing spray. Or if you can go for this kind of gulab water, gulab gel as a finishing spray. Today I'm going to use this. So you have to make sure you don't touch your eyes. So this will make sure your foundation and all the powders are blended nicely. So yeah, this is the finished look. So these are all the products, and I have created today's look with all these products. So yeah, if you like this video, give it a big thumbs, I mean hit on the like button. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'll see you in my next video. Till then, bye.